Home, Iloilo City is the latest city to be placed under a state of calamity due to water shortage brought about by the El Nino weather phenomenon. According to the city government, 17% of their population is affected by the lack of water supply. Now we'll be speaking with Iloilo City Mayor Jerry Treñas, who now joins the Dateline Philippines. Mayor Treñas, mayang hapon.
Hi, Stanley, mayang hapon.
All right. First, give us a sense, perhaps, of the water supply situation in the city right now, and maybe share with us anecdotal accounts of just how scarce water is right now.
The rules for declaration of a state of calamity require that 15% of the population is affected.
Okay.
Our city, RRMO, together with our CENRO, went around the city and made sure how many were affected. And they found out that 17% of the population is now affected because this portion of the population is the sector that relies on shallow wells.
Yeah.
For their water needs, and because 17% of the population is already affected by the El Nino, the City Disaster Risk Reduction Council approved a resolution recommending to the City Council.
Okay.
The declaration of a state of calamity due to the shortage of water. And aside from that declaration, an approval of the use of 2 million plus coming from the quick fund.
Okay.
Of calamity fund.
Okay, so Mayor Treñas, you were saying the city has declared a state of calamity as it exceeded the 15% cap for the number of population, or at least the percentage of population affected by the water supply problem, enabling, of course, the city to use about 12.5 million pesos worth in calamity funds. What are the spending priorities for that fund?
The 12.5 million will be used in a period of 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
So that we will be able to buy potable water, which we will deliver to the barangays affected.
Okay, so this will largely be water distribution. Now, Mayor Treñas, we're seen to grapple with El Nino still in the next month or two. It will affect a lot of residents more. But how is this now affecting the local economy in Iloilo, if you may share with us?
I think it has really affected the local economy in the sense that classes have been suspended.
Right.
Gone up to 44 degrees.
No? Mm-hmm.
And the not so many streets. Business has been affected. Hopefully, this will already end. But the briefing of PAGASA.
Yeah.
Told us that this will still stay for the next 3 months, no? Because regular rainfall will be coming in only by July. As you know, you are from Iloilo.
Right.
The Iloilo is not agricultural anymore.
Right.
Province is, I think, largely slow for the past 3 months.
Okay. Okay, now Mayor Treñas, no, of course, the call is for the public to conserve water to help you out. There are also specific measures, I think, that should be in place to require big business establishments to do their part in conserving water. Has it reached that point where you have appealed to businesses as well to help you conserve?
We talk to business very regularly.
Mm-hmm.
And there is already an appeal to conserve water. And we hope that all these initiatives will be completed soon, like the Halaur Dam. We've been waiting for that. Hopefully it'll happen soon.
All right, on that note, we thank you so much for giving us a situation of water problem and the water supply challenges in Iloilo City. Again, Mayor Jerry Trenas, madamog inyo salamat.
Salamat, Stanley, kag maayog yung naka-istoryanay naman kita.
All right. Good afternoon, sir.